Three, two, one, go. Not bad.
This is the Segway X260, an electric dirt bike. Guys, I am so excited for this one. In this video, we're gonna do an unboxing, setup and assembly, and then first impressions. And then come back in a couple weeks, I'm gonna give you my full in-depth review. So let's get unboxed and get into it. This beast is gonna go 46.6 miles per hour. It only weighs 120-ish pounds. 5 kilowatts. I believe the battery range is like 75 miles or something. These things are super popular. You guys know I love Segway stuff. I reviewed their go-kart over there.
Battery? It's empty.
That's not good. Now I know this is kind of modeled after the Suron. I'll talk more about that probably in my review. There's such a hardcore community on these things of mods and upgrades and even stock default, this 260 should be plenty fast and fun.
220 pounds, I bet it could handle a little bit more than that.
Oh, look at that charging brick.
Sweet fan, all that cooling. This baby says it's gonna output 62 volts at 10 amp. That's insane. Most walls, those things are like 15 amp or something. It's gotta be on its own circuit.
Got nice hydraulic brakes.
Ooh, there we go.
Oh, it's so wide, you know, like of what I'm used to. Great little grips too.
Ooh, that's a sweet, look at that. Even the LED headlamp looks pretty cool.
All right, we got two keys, very nice. Throttle, oh, feels nice. Yes, all my scooters and stuff are always little triggers like this or thumb throttles. To have a full hand throttle, it just can't be beat. Look at that kickstand, man. Now that is a premium kickstand. Sheesh, that's intense. Let's see what's in the goodie box. Full instruction manual, sweet little toolkit, some zip ties. It gives you like the specs of each one of those little parts and pieces. Look at that little diagram on the back. That thing is like pure metal. That's awesome. All right, let's go ahead and release the ratchet strap. Oh, all right, okay, wasn't bad. I was expecting like a massive, you know, pop up or something. Let's do the front one. Ready, set. Oh, there we go, that was a bit more travel. Look at this, got two little ratchet straps to save for a rainy day. The next step is installing the handlebar. Just got this, put this guy on there. So we take off that little plate, put this back on, get it nice and centered. A little hand tighten it first. All right. Okay. Just kidding, take two. There we go. All right, so we're gonna slide this over. I technically did this out of order, should have slid it on before I put those on. There we go, it still works. So slide that one on, then slide on the accelerator. Make sure cables aren't jimmied up. Based upon the marking, gain it centered, kind of feel out what sort of angle or tilt you want on there. Kind of like something right around here. Let's go ahead and cinch it down. All right, there we go. Then I think next step is headlamp. Oh, they just make it so easy. Oh, I want down a little bit, right? It's funny, let's cinch that sucker down. Baby's on there, good. Next step, tighten down throttle and brake. I'm just gonna tighten down a little bit on the accelerator. Then we can do brake next. Oh, it's rubbing on there, do you see that? Look at. I think it's gotta go in that little groove there, because if I push it here, it rubs on that thing. So I actually need to shift that whole thing like that, cinch it down. Overall, they make it really easy. So even if this is like your first dirt bike ever, you know, it's not intimidating, which I like. I've actually had a few gas dirt bikes over the years. It's a little complicated, even the little ones, you know, you got gas, carburetor, loud, smelly. The idea of all electric, silent. So let's install the front wheel. We use the Allen wrench to loosen up the four bolts, take off the two nuts on the front wheel axle, then gently knock and take out the front wheel axle. Install the front wheel in the front fork. Make sure it's well matched with the disc brakes clipper. Insert the front wheel axle, ensure it goes all the way in. Use the 8mm Allen wrench to tighten down both sides of the nut. Tighten down the four bolts on the front fork. All right, guys, we are nearing the end. I can't wait. All we have is the front fender left. Take off these three. Nice and easy. It's triangle formation, so it only goes in one way. Oh, and a quick t-shirt change. It is hot down here in the south in the summer. And last step is putting on the right peg. Now, what's kind of cool is there's three different positions depending on rider height and such. And then also there's these little pinholes
that's gonna cinch it in nice and aligned. The nut comes pre-installed. We just screw that on. Tighten down that 14 mil nut. Oh, there we go. So you push down. All right, so a couple cables need connecting. Built into the battery indicator, charge indicator, which is awesome. Charging port on the left side here. Nice little pull handle. Oh, and that's your master switch right there. That is your battery pack. So cool that they put the X260 design right on there, you know, so it looks good.
This thing is a beast.
It's a 60 volt DC, 32 amp hours, 1920 watt hours. Final step, guys, is just sliding in the battery, connecting the two, one's communication, one's charge, and then we are off to the races. Oh, there we go. It shows off, down, and then on to the right. Okay. It only goes in one way, clicks right in. Love a good click. And then, it said flip the master switch to the right. Woo! Oh, and nothing beats a good little peel. Nice cute little LCD indicator. We got sport mode and EP mode. All right, guys, so we got it all assembled. Not bad at all. Really felt just kind of like a bicycle assembly. Honestly, almost anyone could do this. Even solo would be possible. The hardest part, maybe getting a second person, is putting on that front wheel with the disc brake, making sure you don't bend or break. But yeah, it took us just a couple hours, but that's with filming and brakes. A normal person could probably put this together in like an hour-ish. Not bad at all. All right, so let's go ahead and sit on it. Ooh, first impressions, it feels like a cloud. It's just, it's so soft. Front, rear. All right, let's go ahead and power it on. All right, let's try the horn. You know me, it's gotta have a good horn. All right, I get a little ringing. That's when you know it's good. That's gonna be my new baseline. When it rings your ears, that's when you know. Oh, all right, the kids are asleep. Shh, press that cute little button, 71. Looks like this one already went 0.3 miles maybe, I don't know. All right, let's do a quick little body tour, walkthrough and first impressions. Love the grips, and nice and minimal, but grippy. Cool little display, it's not too in your face, but kind of gets the job done. Sport EP mode, horn button, nice position, hydraulic brakes, super smooth. Love the adjustable suspension, front and rear, tons of travel, which again, it's a dirt bike, you're gonna want, expect that, but it's awesome and exciting. Clean, minimal, but very awesome, modern, and fast looking design. Got adjustable back here, super nice chain. Look at that, ooh, a little tail light. That's really cool. Does it do brake? Oh no, it's just always on. You got that standard shielding for the internals. The seat is again, really like minimal, but it's plush, super cozy seat, nice cushion, little rubber grippies on there. There's a USB port, come check that out. Oh, look at that, a glowing USB port. So you can plug in, let's say your phone and mount it up here for those long rides. By the way, range is almost 75 miles, which is insane. Yeah, so we've got adjustable front shocks, which is really nice. Dial those in per your customization. Just nice foot pegs, good grip. You know, it's just minimalism, which I love. An optional add-on is the front plate. You can either take it on or off. Let's see it without. I think we're gonna go ahead and add it. Cleans up a little bit on the wires, and you just attach it with these four zip ties included. All right, here we go, guys. We are going out for the first test ride. Here's gonna be my first ride impressions. As always, this is something you don't wanna mess around with. Always helmet up. Love that feather throttle. It's super precise. Those brakes. Okay, not too like touchy. You can hear that chain, which is something I'm not used to. Having foot pegs lean back here, that's so different. That suspension though is so smooth. Oh wow. Going up a little mound like that is like butter. All right, something I forgot to do is connect over to the app. Here it is, Dirt eBike 0780. Hold the brake for 3 seconds. Please watch safely, 1 meg data size. Sport mode, speed limit can only be lifted when you complete the tutorial. Isn't that funny? Yeah, baby. Top speed, so I hit 15 miles per hour there. 63 battery percent left. Look at, we got 46 mile range, which is insane. Speed modes. Oh, you can do the twisting force, strong, medium, and regen power recovery. All right. Grips are good, brakes are tight.
opening up the throttle a little bit. It's smooth. Oh, it's so fun. The seat is really cushy. Doesn't feel like a super heavy motorbike or anything, which is awesome. Oh. First impressions, guys. Just went riding 1 or 2 miles, not too much, but wanted to give you my first impressions, how it feels. It looks great. It feels awesome knowing that I'm not gonna get called on. It's not a loud, annoying dirt bike gas engine. It's just, it's silent being electric. You're not turning too many heads, which I personally kind of like. So I love that clean, minimal design up here into the handlebars and switches and everything. Accelerator, brakes, very smooth. Easy to control, which is great. I'd still consider myself a beginner to this dirt e-bike world, and I don't feel too scared on it, but even getting up to 23 miles per hour is super fun, casual, and you feel safe. Love the suspension. I went through just a little bit of grass area here, transitioning up and off onto the sidewalks. It's just so smooth, it feels like a cloud with this massive suspension system, front and rear, great tires. So there is my first impressions and the unboxing assembly of the Segway X260. Huge thanks to RevRide for sending me the 260. I'll give you their link down below. If you're considering this thing, if you're on the fence, man, I don't think you're gonna regret it. Now make sure you guys come back in a couple weeks. I'm gonna just be riding this thing for days on end, trying to get some cool shots, really put it through its paces off, on road, and yeah, come back for my in-depth review coming soon. All right, until next time, guys, let's live authentic.